guys, this is Eli J. Brown / Eli J. Brony, and welcome to another mock video that I have made. And this is a mock of Banjo and Kazooie. I've actually done this sort of thing before, but I went ahead and did an updated version of it because, well, in order to do all of the mock restoration and such, I did have to take some parts from my previous version of a Bionicle Banjo and Kazooie, and so I then went ahead and decided to make another version using any parts that were available, any parts that were spares, and so I have made another Banjo and Kazooie. I'm going to go over what exactly has changed here. I went ahead and used the tan hand pieces from the Star Wars buildable action figure series of sets, and the feet this time around are the Technic pieces, which can be used as feet, but that was not their initial use. A number of these were released in different Technic sets. I believe that you could, I think that you only got this piece once in the Bionicle series, but this piece has been available in a number of other different series of sets, and you can use them for Bionicle mock making. I have been doing that. So I thought that that would work out for the feet, though of course I could have also used the tan feet pieces, but I only had one of those in my parts drawer at the time of the recording of this, so I went ahead and used these pieces instead since I did have them. And the main torso is the same dark brown main body piece, which I think came from a Legends of Chima set, and the brown mask that is spray painted, it's a Stringer Bear mask from Hero Factory's Savage Planet series, put on top of a white 2.0 series Hero Factory Hero Head. And for the legs, well, I used the number 4 long size ones in yellow for the upper legs that's supposed to represent shorts, and then 2 in the reddish-brown color. Not the exact same brown that's shown up here, but you get that idea. I was fortunate that I was able to get another one of these brown armor pieces, the 4 long size. I did use, I only had 5 before. I got them from a Bricklink seller, and they were the only ones that were available at the time because they were quite uncommon pieces, but they are being used again in some new sets. And so somebody on Bricklink had one available, and I got it. So now the number of brown armor pieces in this size in my collection is now even. So that's pretty good. And the blue 5 long armor pieces are used for the straps on his backpack. And speaking of his backpack, this time around I used one of the main body pieces from the original 2001 Toa series. This one right here has those rackets or whatever those were supposed to be broken off. I broke those off. I had to get another one of those pieces off of Bricklink in order to rebuild my 2001 and 2002 versions of Golly, and I did not want either of them to have this, so just went ahead and got a new one, and figured that using this old one could work out, and I don't really mind all that much that it can be shown here, because it's barely noticeable when you look at it from the front anyway. Obviously, this is supposed to depict the backpack, and over on the back, we have Kazooie. This time, she uses a Bo-Rock headpiece as a head because I needed the Furno Eagle mask for bringing back my Furno 3.0. I only had one of those, so I had to use that to make Furno, so I just gave Kazooie a new headpiece, which I actually think works out a lot more better in this instance. The gears, just move her wings so she can flap them using these pieces, I think, that came from the buildable Chima action figure set. So that's Banjo and Kazooie, an updated version. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time.